Hello students, welcome to another session of history. We will continue chapter number 4, the freedom struggle of 1857. The reason behind the struggle of 1857 was economic and political policies of British in India. Since ancient times, there were invasions in India. Many invaders settled in India and were absorbed in the Indian culture. Even though they ruled here, they never made any changes in the basic Indian economic system. Whatever changes took place at the center never affected the village system. The village system continued as it is. But after British rule started in India due to economic policies of British, India started facing economic exploitation, which created a feeling of instability and insecurity in the minds of people. Students, in our previous chapter, we have studied about the economic policies of British, how Britishers brought new land revenue policies and made the payment of tax compulsory in the form of cash. If the farmer failed to pay tax in time, then his land would be confiscated. The British system of land revenue collection differed from place to place, which led to the exploitation of all farmers. As a result of it, the agriculture system collapsed. To sell the British goods in India and enjoy profit was the policy of the British. They imposed heavy taxes on the local industries. The handicraft and textile industry of India were ruined. Many Indian artisans became unemployed. This led to the discontent in the mind of Indians against the British. The Indians felt that the Britishers were interfering in the culture, tradition, and customs of India, such as Sati Prohibition Act, which was passed by Lord William Bentinck in 1829, and Widow Remarriage Act, which was passed by Lord Dalhousie in 1856. These acts were responsible for the social reforms, but the Indians thought that it is an interference in their lifestyle and hence they were dissatisfied. After 1757, the British took charge of many Indian states. Lord Dalhousie annexed many princely states. The Nawab of Ayodhya was dethroned on grounds of maladministration, means he was blamed that he is misusing his powers, whereas the princely states of Satara, Nagpur and Jhansi were also annexed through the doctrine of lapse. Doctrine of lapse means if any Indian ruler dies without leaving a male heir, means successor, his kingdom would automatically pass over to the British. Due to such policies of Dalhousie, the Indians did not consider the British as trustworthy. There was discontent among Indian soldiers as they were given low status by the British officers. They could not gain any post higher than the Subedar. They were paid very less compared to the British soldiers. The allowances were also gradually decreased. Due to these reasons, there were growing discontent among the Indian soldiers. In 1856, the British provided long enfiled rifles to the Indian sepoys. The sepoys were required to bite the end of the cartridges while using them. Later, they came to know that these cartridges were smeared in the fats of cow and pig. Due to this, the religious sentiments of Hindu and Muslim sepoys were hurt and made them unhappy. Indian sepoys were forced to use these rifles. Severe punishments were given to those sepoys who refused to use it. In reaction to this unjust nature of British officers, Mangal Pandey from Barakpur cantonment shot an English officer. Mangal Pandey was then arrested and hanged to death. This news spread like fire that Mangal Pandey was hanged. The entire regiment of Indian sepoys at Meerut took part in the freedom struggle and marched towards Delhi. Regiment means a group of soldiers in the army. The entire group of soldiers of Indian sepoys gathered at Meerut and marched towards Delhi. Thousands of Indians voluntarily joined them on the way. They handed over the leadership of the freedom struggle to Mughal Emperor Bahadur Shah and declared him as the Emperor of India.